Good morning. I did just do a community post about this, but I thought this might be a good opportunity to add to my Straight Out of Context video playlist and to introduce new subs that I've gotten in the last several weeks to that playlist. And, you know, I'm a huge proponent of honest handling of scripture. Not flippant handling of the Word of God. I've talked a lot in different posts recently about approaching the scriptures in an honest way, in context, using scripture to interpret scripture, so that we don't go with, if we go to the Word with a presupposed idea of what things are supposed to mean, we've already got our mind made up what we want it to say. And then we go and we cherry pick or whatever and grab things out of context to support our preconceived notions, then we're not renewing our mind. You know, we as believers, we have both the mind of the flesh and the mind of the spirit, and, you know, like the mind of Christ. And we go to the Word of God to renew our fleshy mind to line up with the truth of the Word of God. And we can't do that if we're just going there to misuse scripture in a way that just has us continue on in our error, the way that we think is right, whereas it may not always be right, you know? So, and I, you know, the Straight Out of Context series is, you know, in what I like to call churchianity, there are many verses that are always used flippantly and casually. You know, we like to put them on t-shirts. We like to pick them out of context and put them on t-shirts and put them on mugs and use them in social media posts and things like that in a way that they were never originally intended to be used. And sometimes it's pretty harmless, right? But other times it's really not harmless at all, depending on how it's being used. And one of them here in Hosea 4:6, it says, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge." They take the first part of that verse. And the way I've seen it used pretty much every time is to frighten or seduce believers into thinking, going and listening to sources of wisdom that are more worldly wisdom or knowledge apart from God, when really, you know, and a lot of times it's sensationalism. I've seen it used about the, you know, the jab and things like that. But anyway, it's been going on for a long time, and they use it for different similar purposes, sensationalism and things like that. But, you know, here, if you look in chapter 4, verse 1, you'll see that he's talking about the knowledge of God. That sets the context. We use scripture to interpret scripture, and he's talking to the nation of Israel. Back in the Old Testament, it was under the Mosaic Law, and they were committing spiritual adultery. They had turned from God and turned to little g gods, and you know, just abandon the way of the Lord altogether. And it's the knowledge of God that they had abandoned. And he says, as you, if you continue on there in verses, it says, "I will, because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee." Right? And they did not care to know God in their minds. Remember, there's another verse, I can't remember where it is right now, where he says, they didn't care to acknowledge God or care to know him, that they were turned over, you know, to their own lust and all of that. I think that's when he was talking about homosexuality and things like that in particular at that time. But that's beside the point. The point is that this verse is used not to tell believers in the church today that we should pursue all, you know, like we need to be consumed with watching the news headlines or chasing conspiracy theories or extra canonical books of the Bible, things like that. And it's interesting to me that the Lord was warning them about, you know, abandoning God in their knowledge and spiritual fornication or spiritual adultery. And a lot of times, or at least some of the time, if not most of the time, people are using this verse to get believers to do just that, at least on some level. You know, as a believer, we don't have to chase after all those things for safety and wisdom and validation and to be on the right path. We have what we need in His Word. We just believe on the Lord and we walk by faith and not by sight, you know. And we grow in the knowledge of the Lord and not in these worldly sources that may or may not be correct, right? So I just wanted to share that with you guys. And I do plan on coming back in a day or two, Lord willing, with my next video Bible study in Philippians. And I love you guys. Have a great day.